Good morning, John. So obviously I just turned 30. And in general, I'm realizing that I'm no longer what you would call a young person. And besides the fact that I just received the best birthday present that anyone has ever received from people from Basra to Ohio, there is a tiny bit of bitterness to this whole being 30 thing, and I kind of wanted to talk about. See, what this is making me realize, I wouldn't mind being young forever. So, you know, immortality. I can have it. So there's a bunch of different paths that you could take to get to immortality, and I'm going to talk about 10 of them right now. Path number one, hoping for good medicine. I mean, let's be honest. There are tons of people, hard-working, good people, working their butts off to eliminate the diseases that kill people. So all we gotta do is cure heart disease and cancer and all that stuff until life expectancy starts to go up more than 1 year per year, and then you're good. All you gotta do is make it to that point, and then they'll always be fixing whatever's wrong with you before it actually happens. Or, at least, before it kills you. Path number two, travel for a long period of time at near the speed of light. Now, I'm not gonna pretend that I understand why this is, but apparently, if you're traveling near the speed of light, time passes more slowly for you compared to the rest of the universe. So if I get in a spaceship that goes to the speed of light, I get in it and I go, and then I come back and it takes me like 2 years, on Earth, many years will have passed. And then, hopefully, they will have cured whatever was wrong with me. Path number three, cryonics, is basically the same thing as speed of light travel, except that freezing, it's a little less cool. Honestly. Path number four, bathe in the blood of virgins. Just get it in your hair there. You know, it's, it restores your youth. At least that's what Elizabeth Bathory thought. So I don't know whether that works or not. I'm not saying it doesn't work, but I'm probably going to steer clear of that one anyway. Path number five, the singularity. Futurist Ray Kurzweil believes that there is a point at which machines will be able to build machines that are smarter than themselves. And then from then on, they will just continue building smarter and smarter machines forever, and the explosion in intelligent machinery will change everything. This includes, theoretically, the machines helping us save ourselves. Which is funny, because that's not how it happens in science fiction. Once the machines get smarter than us, no matter what, they're not like, oh, thanks for creating us, here's immortality! No, generally they see you as less useful than a fly, and they swat you. Path number six, be a jellyfish! There's one kind of jellyfish, it's called the immortal jellyfish, which can shift back and forth between its polyp stage and its adult form. And it can do this perpetually, meaning, basically, that it can just live forever. It is literally immortal. Also, I'm probably not gonna go this route because being a jellyfish doesn't sound very fun. Path number seven, selective breeding. This would take a very long time. Also, it would take a very dedicated and evil dictator. So if some evil immortality-crazed dictator was like, you cannot have sex until you are 50, then all of the children born of that generation would be guaranteed to be stronger than children born of, like, 20-year-olds, because the 20-year-olds would have had to have reached the age of 50. Now, over thousands of years of doing this, you actually select for people who live longer. And then you start saying you can't have sex until you're 60, and then 70, and then 80, and then 90. It would work, but it would be really evil. Path number eight, telomerase. Telomeres are the things that cap our chromosomes there at the end there, and scientists think that telomeres breaking down is the reason that we get older. All of the stuff, our skin getting saggy, our brains getting stupid, our bodies falling apart, all that stuff caused by telomeres breaking down. Now, there's an enzyme that actually repairs telomeres, and it's called telomerase, and mice that are genetically engineered to produce more of this stuff live 50% longer than other mice. Why aren't they putting that in vitamin water? Path number eight, let someone turn you into a robot. Lots of futurists think that we'll either be putting our brains into robot bodies, or we'll actually be downloading the thoughts and memories that comprise ourselves into computers, which I'm pretty sure and pretty happy that I'm not going to live to see. It sounds very interesting, but it does not sound like what I have come to think of as life. And finally, path number 10, trees. Here's how this one works. When you turn 30, you have to have an awesome enough brother to get a bunch of people to organize and plant trees and other plants so that when you die, there will be trees that were planted because of you. And you will be dead, but the trees will still be there, being beautiful and living their lives. John and everyone who helped out with my amazing birthday, thank you all so much.